video we have seen the nomenclature of the alkyl halide and the aryl halide. Now in this video we are going to study the nature of CX bond. Nature of CX bond. Now what the bond says, what is the nature of the bond? It means whether the bond is polar bond or non-polar. Now what is polar bond and what is non-polar bond? Polar and then it is non-polar. If electronegative difference exists in a compound, if electronegative difference exists in a compound, are said to be polar. And very simple. If electronegative difference is zero, if electronegative difference is zero, are said to be non-polar. Now, what does it mean? If electronegative difference exists in a compound, are said to be polar. So, what is electronegative difference? Electronegative difference kya? Kaise pata chalega? Aise take example CH4. Suppose it is a compound. Or we are taking an example of CX. No? Well, if we take CCl. Now, we say that it is a polar bond. So, here comes polar bond. It means there exists electronegative difference. Now, the electronegativity difference in the electronegativity of carbon is 2.2 and that of Cl is 3.2. Now, if we subtract, we get delta x, xCl minus xCl, 3.2 minus 2.2, that is 1.2. So, here we get the value of delta x. Now, non-polar, you can take example here, Cl2x. Cl, that is 3.2, and again XCl, that is 3.2. Now delta X equals to 0. So here the electronegative difference becomes 0, then this compound is said to be non-polar, and here electronegative difference exists, so these are said as a polar compound. Now we are reading nature of CX bond. Since halogen atoms are more electronegative than carbon atoms, the carbon halogen bond of an alkyl halide is polarized. The carbon atom bears partial positive charge and halogen atom possesses partial negative charge. Now see, it is an example of alkyl halide. So carbon possesses partial positive charge, it means it becomes partial delta, and halogen atom possesses partial negative charge, that means minus. Okay, so this is the nature of CX bond. Since halogen atoms are more electronegative, yes, halogen atoms, X, suppose here is X stands for Cl, X stands for Cl, then electronegativity is 3.2, and carbon XC, that is 2.2. So in terms of value also, the halogen atoms are more electronegative than carbon atom. So the halogen bond of the CX bond is the polarized bond. The carbon atom bears, due to which carbon atom bears partial positive charge, and halogen atom bears partial negative charge. Now, if the value of X changes, it means X agar aapka fluorine, then it becomes chlorine, then it becomes iodine. Okay, and then bromine, and then it is iodine. So what will be the changes on the bond length and bond enthalpy? What will be the change in the bond length and bond enthalpy? We are going to see now. Now here we are going to see is it on bond length. Now the carbon halogen bond length increases from CF to CI, means the carbon halogen bond length increases from CF to CI. CF to CI. Why? Because the size also increases from chlorine to chlorine, chlorine to then bromine, and then to iodine. So, CF se jada chlorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Similarly, if we see RF, then it is greater than RCl, then it is RBr, and then gradually, as we move down the group, किसी भी अगर group में अगर ऊपर से नीचे आते हैं, then gradually the size increases from top to bottom. Similarly, if the size increases of the halogen atom, if the size increases of the halogen atom, then automatically the bond length also increases. RF से ज़्यादा bond length RCl, then it is RBr and then RI. Similarly. So this was effect on bond length. So the nature of bond length also seen. Now effect on bond enthalpy. Now effect on bond enthalpy. So we know that as the bond length increases, the bond enthalpy, bond length increases, bond enthalpy decreases. Means it shows the inverse relationship. There is an inverse relationship between bond length and bond enthalpy. Bond enthalpy. So, for bond length, we have a sequence. For bond length, we have a sequence. RF is greater than RCl, then RBr, and then RI. It was for bond length. Now, here we have a relation that bond length is inverse relation in bond enthalpy. So, the sequence becomes inverse. Sequence becomes inverse. It means, for the bond enthalpy, RF has a greater value than RCl, then RBr, and then RI. Well, that is a bond enthalpy. So, in this particular video, we have seen the nature of CX bond. Now, we are going to see that methods of preparation of haloalkanes and haloarenes or the alkyl light in the coming videos. Thank you.